During the Second World War, the German Air Force, the Luftwaffe, undertook a strategy of sustained bombing of Britain, known as the Blitz. Beginning on the 7th of September 1940, the capital city of London was bombed initially for 57 consecutive nights. London was not the only target of this lightning war. 80 miles away in the south coast city of Southampton, German reconnaissance had identified key targets. These were military aircraft builders, Supermarine Aviation Works, and the docks. Between the 20th of June 1940 and 15th of July 1944, German aircraft dropped 30,000 incendiary and 2,500 high explosive bombs on the city. 44,000 properties damaged or destroyed, and 2,354 casualties, including 577 dead.
So here we are in Southampton High Street in 2008. The High Street's been here for about 1,000 years. It's seen tremendous amount of change in that time, but probably the biggest change was between 1938 and today. And most of that has been caused by the bombing in 1940. Huge chunks of the High Street just disappeared overnight. Holyrood Church was set alight by incendiaries and burnt down. The Dolphin survived just 3 doors further up the street, so it was very random as to which bits made it through the war. The rebuilding after the war was on quite a small scale. It was difficult to get hold of materials, so mostly it was three-story buildings. And it's perhaps only a matter of time before the High Street regenerates again and we see a new view looking up towards the Bargate.
December 19th, 1939. The great festival of Christmas is spoiled this year, for all the shops are darkened and the blackout makes night shopping a misery.
It was interesting from the our point of view because we just didn't know anything about air raids until that first blitz.
When the planes came over, you knew that they were dropping bombs, and it was very, very noisy. The sky used to light up. I mean, as you went up the garden, it was like daylight with the lights, you know, coming down. And we had a bomb through the at the bottom of the garden. It went through the wall. It sort of blew up in the bottom of the garden, and you knew then that the next one could be on you.
This is the sort of place where people spent the night during the Second World War. We're underneath the old town of Southampton in one of the air raid shelters. The shelters were converted from the medieval wine vaults, and hundreds of people had to shelter in these structures, perhaps for a few hours, but maybe all night. And you wouldn't know when you came out if your house had survived or whether perhaps people you know would be dead. Must have been a very scary time. These vaults were chosen because they were so strongly constructed. Most of the houses above ground are quite flimsy brick, but these are the vaults to protect the wine that belonged to the medieval merchants who made Southampton rich. So the walls down here are about 4 feet thick and will protect the people from the bombs.
January 19th, 1941. Had a trek to the docks this afternoon and passed through the bombed High Street. The first time I have seen the damage.
The early raids on Southampton caused considerable havoc. The docks' ARP control post was destroyed and other damage proved very extensive. Major casualties of the bombing of the docks were a flour mill and the great cold storage depot there. Raging fires consumed a month's rations for the whole of southern England. The heat of the blazing fats and foodstuffs was so intense that most of the water from the firemen's hoses turned to steam before it reached the flames. When the conflagration at last subsided, the ruined shells of offices, warehouses and sheds remained everywhere.
When we got up out into the High Street, we went up through Ogle Road. Well, it was just devastation. And everything was burning. It was just burning. And there was all these shops there, no windows, and they're all burning away. Everything was burning.
After the raid was over, our chaps used to go along and pick up these unexploded incendiary bombs and toss them in the drink, in the water. And today, if you had an incendiary bomb found anywhere, they'd have the squad in to take it away. What we did was to do our best to usher those people who were not being injured out into the open air and make sure they were all right. But I'm afraid with the people who were dead, they were under piles and piles of debris, and it took several days for the recovery forces to get them out and take the bodies to the mortuary.
April 11th, 1941. In Bitton Road, a big house laid flat, not a wall standing. Underneath the wreckage, they found the body of Uriah Eads, a joiner I knew well. I was passing by as they brought him out.
So after the Blitz, the town was rebuilt. It took about 20 years. Building materials were in short supply, but finally the town was reconstructed. The people of Southampton also had to reconstruct their lives, and that was perhaps a harder thing to do.
It's different. No good pretending it isn't. It's not easy to live on your nerves. That's what you do.
But what can one do in those circumstances except try and reassure the people who have been, who had escaped?
August 11th, 1943. I was out of work a hell of a long time. Never had any money. Yet our pleasures were simple and few. And our minds were free from air raids.